Oh, here you go. Good. Perfect. Yeah. So anyways, hey, so this is what, the fourth season already?
Fourth season.
What is the secret that for you guys, for the success of after all these years? Who wants it?
I think it's the real answer, I think, is our friendship, right? It's the fact that we're best friends. We've been best friends for 25 years now. Yep. And that keeps the show real and horrible and awesome at the same time.
The fake answer is that we pay everyone $1,000 to watch a show every week.
Well, how long have you guys been friends? I mean, when was the start?
I met in high school 26 years ago. Yeah. So
freshman year of high school we met. I think in religion class.
Yeah. Religion class? Yeah. What, do you guys just start playing practical jokes inside a religious class?
We went to an all-boys Catholic high school, so there was nothing to do
There's no girls that are going to prank each other the whole time.
Yeah. That is one of the things. I mean, it's all four men. I mean, when are you guys going to add women into this show?
As soon as we could go back in time and add women to our high school. Yeah. Trust me, we would love to. I didn't start dating until like my mid-20s. Yeah.
But the problem is no women will hang out with us. That's where the problem is.
So how do you guys come up with the jokes? I mean, after 4 years, I probably ran out of jokes. I mean, you guys just keep on coming up with more and more and more.
Well, we're a professional improv troupe. We formed a troupe in 1999 called the Tenderloins, and we've been doing comedy a long time. And the show basically just is we're trying to make each other laugh and make ourselves look stupid. So there's so many ways to do that. I think that's really what makes it easy.
So when you guys come up with the jokes, you partner up, group up, or just do it by yourself?
Well, plot sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, we secretly plot against each other all the time. You know, I'll say to Joe, and a lot of times what we'll do is if we want to test an idea out to see if it's, you know, I'll say, Joe, what do you think about if we do this to Sal? And if he says it's good, if he likes the idea, then I'm secretly going to do it to him, yeah.
Is it more fun to do the jokes against each other or against us common folks that we have no clue?
The common folk is fun to mess with. But really, we're really just making each other look like jerks, and that's really what the fun is.
Yeah, we're never out to embarrass the public at all. The public is just there to witness our embarrassment.
And they mostly just think we're absolutely nuts.
Have you guys ever, like, got angry at each other for a joke that has gone too far? I mean, it has to have been, right?
Well, I mean, you know, they threw me out of an airplane last season against my will.
He's still talking about it. He won't get over it.
I mean, I could have died.
A parachute.
The guy on my back had a parachute. I was not wearing a parachute. That's a fact.
Yeah, that was a mistake. He wasn't supposed to have a parachute.
Is there any type of jokes that just plainly cross the line that either of you would not do?
Well, I mean, you know, I married Sal's sister. That joke kind of crosses the line. Marriage, legal marriage in the state of New York kind of crosses the line.
Yeah, we try not to be mean, especially to old people and pretty women. And I think that's really what happens to us.
If it's an old pretty woman, I'm screwed.
there we go. So what do we expect this upcoming season? Just more of the same or even bigger and better?
Well, it's funny. We're saying Sal actually hits a bad rut. Sal had a rough couple months, so he gets hit pretty hard the second half of the season.
we do a whole episode in New Orleans this season. Yeah. And then we have a punishment that actually is death-defying. We dressed Joe as a superhero, made him ride on top of the Roosevelt Island tram hundreds of feet above the East River. That was terrifying.
I was Captain Fatbelly.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That was me, so, yeah.
And I do have to mention that you are at Comic-Con. Have you guys played any practical jokes so far?
For fun, but not anything professionally.
Maybe.
Just more screwing with drunk people as they walk around Comic-Con.
I mean, it's amazing here at 1:30 a.m. to walk up and down, Market Street. It's unbelievable.
Well, that's awesome. Well, anyways, thank you. I thought the practical joke was on me when you guys invited me for breakfast. And I was like, where's the breakfast? And all you had was the mini pancakes.
Here's the joke. This is the breakfast. That's
enjoy.
Wait, thanks. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Give my part. Okay, back.
Thank you.